I work on two projects till now. I will go my first project. In the first project, the client will upload the data every week, some Excel files on every month, 9 different files for every month. And I have to upload that files and cleaning that file and upload it into BigQuery in GCP. GCP is nothing but Google Cloud Platform. I use OpenPY Excel because the files which are getting from the client is Excel files because BigQuery does not allow Excel files to load the data. So I have used OpenPY Excel. Why I am use OpenPY Excel, right? After 2015, there is called an MDASH. What is MDASH means? If you concatenate two MDASH, it will become MDASH. The ASCII keyword is U 2015. In Pandas, it is not acceptable. So I use OpenPY Excel for that purpose only. For cleaning that data, I use Pandas and have uploaded for cleaning purpose. There are some business logic on it. I have uploaded the data into BigQuery and joined some two tables into a final table. There, in my team, there was two members, me and another one. There, he will take that table into Data Fusion. Data Fusion is nothing but it is a manipulation of tables in BigQuery. After that, he will do some manipulations on a business logic, how client wants. And after that, it will the resultant data, what are getting from the 9 tables, it will get into one table. After that,
proceed and complete it.
Yeah, okay. After that, resultant data will be coming. The frequency of the data will be every week it will be coming 9 same files. After every month, 9 different files will be coming. My second project is on ideas to migration project from ideas to Amazon S3, from Amazon S3 to Databricks, where I have used Hadoop, Hive, Impala, and Oozie, and in a Databricks, Apache Spark in Python.
Can you please brief us just architectural view that what exactly your second project and from where it will start and from where it will
end? In the second project, it is a very big project. It has, I think it has 22 TB of data where separate categories are there in that project. My project is like migration where the data which previously is captured the tables and in Hive and data are stored in Hadoop. So our target is like, we are 4 members. Our target is like that Hadoop with DistCP, we have to take that files to Amazon S3 bucket. From Amazon S3 to we have Databricks where that Hadoop has sequence file. So the client want to us to a Parquet format. Firstly, he want like to be a Parquet format in a Databricks, so we are converting him. Later in the middle of the project, he suddenly changed that. I want in Delta Lake, not Data Lake, Delta Lake in a Databricks. So we have take that Parquet sequence file to Parquet. Some of the half of the project is completed, which we are converted sequence to Delta. We are converted to Parquet to Delta. After which are not converted, we are converted sequence to Delta Parquet. And we have some fulfillments in that project, like there are 7 fulfillments that is government related. And we had to take some shell scripts based on the Hive query in some other Hadoop only. My term is like we have to take Uzi, like where it is the top of our Hadoop, where we have to flow a workflow, like a flow chart. And we had to take some workflow, which script is take first, and what are the outputs taken from the first script, we continue to second script like that.
Okay, you said the huge amount of data around 20 plus TB, right?
Yeah. How? That is 22 TB means that project is related to that TB of data, but it is a considered of many projects. My project is like something which has in Hadoop, like maximum is 1 TB to 2 to 3 TB maybe. We have to that take to 2 TB like a sprint, like sprint wise we have agile format. So for first sprint, we have to take some data and convert it into Delta Parquet, Databricks times, and the other we have to some take that like. That we so many projects are working on that ideas. That ideas is nothing but is a compromise of Hadoop, of having data like 22 TB.
Yeah, we'll go one by one. Okay, we'll go
Yes,
with the
sir.
budget. So first, my question is, how frequently this data can be transferred from source to your data lake, like in EDW environment?
Yeah, the frequently is like we have tables like they have some partitions
No,
like load
trying to
here and load
understand the
mark.
question. Is it delta load or full load? If it is so, will it happen every day or weekly or monthly? What is the frequency of
Oh,
data?
frequency, you are talking about frequency. Yeah, it is daily basis.
Daily basis to migrate the data from source system to Hadoop environment. What is the tool that you are using?
From source to Hadoop is like there are separate team is there for mainframe team, all of them. My part is like Hadoop to Amazon S3.
All right, you are creating tables. Means this data is stored in tables, right? In Hive.
The tables are which are in already present in Hive. Already
Okay.
present in Hive.
Okay, right.
It's
So what
a
is
partition format.
Parquet format?
Partition format. Yeah, in sequence file.
So these tables are internal table or external table?
This is external table.
Okay, these are partition tables or external tables?
Yeah, it is a partition table.
Static partition or dynamic partition?
Dynamic partition it
Can you please explain the difference between static and dynamic partition?
Yeah. Static partition is nothing but see. For example, we have to insert like we have to give. For example, we have load year and load month. For example, we have to give like load year is equal to 8 and load month is equal to 220. For example, it is a static. We have to give manually the data to static table. Dynamic is nothing but we have to manually do whatever it may be 2020, 2080. Dynamically, we have to present not like manually.
What is the query? Can you please give me one query? How it will vary when we load data into dynamically or statically?
For example, I will tell you load data in from lighting in the local area it may be path name and partition load year is equal to 2020 and load year month is equal to table into the table name.
Okay, I will give you one scenario. I have one external table, like let us say non-partition is there. Let us say A table is non-partition, B table is partition table. Okay, now you have to transfer data, you have to load data from A table to B table. B table is partition, A table is non-partition. Tell me now. I need query Hive.
Insert overwrite table partition by into from we have to select that select statement.
What is the scope of PySpark over there in your project?
PySpark is like basically he use like Hive is only for querying the data for data analysis and it is a data warehouse tool. But PySpark is a programmatically where we have a data frames, RDD, clustering of data. So it is a fault tolerance and also we have to take tables and we have to read table through Python easily.
So by using Hive, I cannot do all these things.
Hive is like SQL format. Like through PySpark we can use through Python as much as through PySpark SQL.
Can you please tell me major differences between this Hive and PySpark?
Hive and PySpark.
Yeah.
Hive is PySpark like PySpark is processing speed is high. Through PySpark we can take that Hive generate our enablement Hive in PySpark also.
How PySpark is faster than Hive?
It has great processing speed like it is a distributed in a nature distributed cluster in nature and through PySpark we can connect Hive also but
No, I'm not asking that question. I want major differences between Hive and PySpark.
we get processing speed like from Hive is like it is work on the top of the MapReduce. It works on MapReduce stack. But in a PySpark, it has its same execution engine for memory scheduling and for fault tolerance and task scheduling. We have the DAG. We have like recovery of data in PySpark. We can recover like if we middle of the data, we can take from DAG. From DAG, we can take that data. In Hive, we cannot do that. Like we have to take from again. We have to start in as a MapReduce from start one.
Once you developed a program in Spark, then most of the submission in Spark How many modes we have?
It has a cluster mode and a client mode.
Difference between cluster mode and client mode?
Cluster mode is suppose this a machine, we are submitting the data where we have to submit that driver within a machine, where the client is sitting somewhere else, and we have to submit the data over the machine which is not there in the corresponding, or some far away, like that.
In client mode, okay. Where Spark okay. driver gets created.
So client mode, I will tell you, like suppose this is a user, then you are submitting the data. These are the machines. Like when you submit the data, these are the worker nodes where you have. If you submit the data, this will take as a driver mode, and this one worker node will be created. In cluster mode, these are the data where we have driver mode and connect to the worker node in the cluster mode.
Let us okay. say I'm executing one query on Hive. So how internally okay. it will happen?
Hive actually is like we have based on the Hive servers, like through applications is like Hive query engine. On top of that, we have like from BLN command or JDBC or Threat server we have to take. And the components will be parser, semantic analyzer, logic generation, and type checking.
My question is very simple. I think many yes. times you might have run Hive query, right?
Yeah.
But you know, in Hue, we will get on web UI, right? Output.
Yes.
So yeah, yeah. What exactly will happen internally?
Internally, that Hive query is converted into MapReduce jobs.
Okay.
Yeah.
What is the Thrift server in Hive?
Thrift server?
Yeah. What is Thrift server?
I don't know.
Okay.
What are the optimization techniques you are aware of in Hive?
In Hive, optimization techniques like be partitioning and bucketing, and we have vectorization, and we can use stage execution engines. I have worked on partitioning and bucketing.
Mm-hmm. What is the exact difference between bucket and partitions? When do we use partitions? When do we use buckets?
Basically, partition is like a folder, and bucketing is like a file. If you for bucketing, it will take for example. If you have further data, like forecast data or something, like we have to partitions like year wise, so we have to create that data like 2010 we have, 2020, 2011, like that. And bucketing will be like Maharashtra data, like Andhra Pradesh data, like Tamil Nadu data. Bucketing will be separate this way. It will have sample of data slice. Like we have to cluster, mm-hmm. we have to into five buckets. Basically, partition mm-hmm. is like a folder, and bucketing is like a file.
Mm-hmm. How do you define the buckets to a particular table?
For bucket, we are taking syntax. We are telling syntax, right?
Mm-hmm.
Syntax is like clustered by something like where we have to create like a state. Or something ID cluster by into how many buckets, like five buckets or six buckets, two buckets, like that.
Mm-hmm. Have you defined any bucket anytime?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Can we define buckets on top of partitions?
No.
What about partitions on top of buckets?
Partitions on top of bucket.
Buckets?
Yeah. Like we have really, partition, it will exist. Like we have to divide partitions. Along with that, we have to divide, in that partition, we have to divide like buckets.
Mm-hmm. Can't we create the buckets outside the partitions, inside the partitions?
Yeah, we can create inside that partition. Like that's why I'm saying
outside,
like a partition.
What about
like
outside? Outside the partitions?
Outside the partition, no, I don't think. Outside the partition, like without partition, you can do it like a bucket.
Have you done any time without the partition? Have you created any bucket?
No. Basically, I have used the partition. So by after that, the buckets.
Okay. What are all the file formats you are aware of in Hive?
In Hive, they have sequence file format, text file formats, ORC file formats. Like ORC is the best for Hive. Like we have a vectorization ORC reader for that. What is sequence file format?
What is the difference between ORC to Parquet?
ORC to Parquet. For ORC, get output. It will give output data like only one file. Like Parquet, it will give number of files as an output. For data compression, data type compression is ORC is best. And for nested data structure, Parquet is best. And we have ASCII transactions in Parquet. ASCII transaction is good for ORC format. And for ORC is basically used in ORC is basically used in Hive. And Arrow, Drill, we are use Parquet.
Can we use Parquet in Hive?
Yeah, we can use Parquet in Hive because we have to use some like what we say, SDI row format.
What about the ORC file format?
ORC file format. ORC file format is basically ORC file format basically. ORC is defined from the basically there will be ORC file format where the compressions and all these things is difficult from that. So after ORC is defined from that, I think 1.4 or 1.5 maybe versions, ORC file format is declared for the difficulties comes from the ORC file format.
What kind of difficulty you are facing with that? What are those difficulties?
Difficulties might be data type schema evaluation and compression and like what we call for what that is like read write performance in ORC.
In ORC, these are all well and good, and rest of the file formats. It's not that much.
Not in desktop format. I am comparing with ORC file format.
ORC file format? Can you come up again?
Sorry, I didn't get it.
Can you come up again?
ORC file format.
ORC file format and ORC.
Yeah, ORC file format is basically before ORC format there will be an ORC format. Where we have data type compression and it is a row columnar format, so we have to take read or write performance schema evaluation. For that, we have to come with the ORC file format.
Okay. How do you define the creator name for the table schema?
With the table properties. TBL properties.
Which property?
TBL properties in Hive, right? With the TBL properties, where we have to use that whoever that created name.
Okay. What is custom Saturday?
Sorry?
Custom Saturday. Have you heard about the Saturday?
Yes, SDI, right? Serializer and deserializer. SUD is like SUD is serializer is like when we are transferring over the network, it will convert into byte format and deserialize in like the data from that storing that data into a like what we get object dot format. So we have to take
it. Custom Saturday?
Custom Saturday? No, I have not written that. Like, so I've heard that one, custom Saturday. Yeah, user defined functions, I have worked on it. In Spark, we have
used the different. Give me a scenario where you have defined the UDF.
Where? In Hive or Spark?
In Hive. On which purpose you have defined the UDF format?
In Hive, actually, I have not used like a Hive for user defined function. In Spark, I have used basically for optimization purpose. We don't want to use like UDF. It will take shuffling of data like that. And scenario in Hive, like basically, I have not worked on things in Hive. So. For a particular field, yeah.
Okay. What is merge sort bucket? Have you used any time?
Merge sort bucket. Merge sort, sort merge joins like sort merge or merge, I think sort merge and sort merge bucket join is same thing like where if you want to combine that two tables, it will take that, for example, if your table A has bucketing, table B has bucketing, it will take that two tables or the corresponding buckets, we have to take that data to join. And after that, two tables are same corresponding buckets.
What is the purpose of that?
Purpose of like if the two tables is in a big big if that two tables has a large large data set like in broadcast time we do not lose like that in we cannot use that broadcast time for that purposes and if we have large data sets we have to combine that for natural joint or normal joint, we have something of data. So it will take that only for that particular bucket, it will join in that system.
Is it mandatory that the partition column is common to both of the tables or different while doing the merge sort bucket?
Sorry, come again.
Is it mandatory that the partition column is same for both of the tables or not?
Partition.
Doing the merge sort bucket.
Merge sort buckets partitioning. I do maybe not, but that what we are connecting that ID will be that same bucket that one.
Which ID?
Where we are connecting that merging buckets, right? Connecting that two joints.
Okay. How do you load the data in the incremental fashion in using Scoop? How do you do that?
Scoop is nothing but I think a scoop is from loading data from RDMMS to from Hadoop systems. I have not worked on scoop.
Okay, fine. So what in Spark? What is the difference between collapse and repartition?
Repartition is like repartition is like we have to increase for if you have some partitions like three, we have to decrease or increase, we have to use repartition. And coalesce is like to decrease the partition. For optimization purpose, coalesce is best. like in a repartition, it's shuffling of the data in Colis, but for optimization techniques for performance on
Colis. What is D-stream?
D-stream, it is a Spark streaming. D-stream is like, actually we are getting, Spark is a real-time processing, but it is not. Like, we are getting the data, but it is converted into micro batches. That D-streams take that, for if you are using Spark streaming, it will detect checkpoints, and after that, we can take that micro batches in the D-streams and convert it.
What are the types of checkpoints are available in Spark streaming?
Checkpoints? No, I don't know.
What is sliding window?
No, sorry, I didn't know. Window, I know that one. Window function creating that.
Okay. What is distributed caching?
Distributed cache is nothing but it is an in-memory wherever we want to store that one. It has a default value as 10 GB in it has a default value 10 GB. Whenever we want to take the data in whenever we some like a map joins, we have to do the like that. So we have to take when we are converting on the map side, it will take that tables in the hash tables and then it is converted into distributed cache where it is an in-memory computation. Like whenever you get take there's not shuffle of data, it will take that from that distributed cache and give operations on it. Default value is 10 GB in distributed cache.
Hadoop can use distributed cache for in-memory processing, right?
Yeah.
As per my understanding, you are telling.
No. We can also use in Hive distributed cache.
Anywhere in Hive. Yeah. And in Hadoop and Hadoop ecosystem uses the distributed cache for in-memory computations.
Yes, yeah.
Yeah. Why people are going for Spark?
See, why we are going, like, see, for specifically, we have Hadoop ecosystem, so we have specific kind, like for batch processing, we have MapReduce job. For iterative, we have Apache Sage, and for streaming data, we have Apache Flink is there. Spark combines like all the data, like we have Spark SQL and RDD data frames and the data sets which we want, and we have Spark ML Libvirt, Spark streaming.
In the same way, in Hadoop ecosystem, Hadoop also there are different ecosystems to do the activities, right?
Yeah. But in Spark, like we have this whole systems in a one package, right? We have execution engine where we have to use for machine learning. We have to use separate category where we have Spark engine whatever it may be in the Databricks. We have separate cluster mode like a higher standard in apart from the Databricks, we have to use like Yarn, Mesos, like that. It is had a separate one package, but we have, whenever we use like these things, we have separate category.
Okay, fine. Can we define the buckets of different regions with the same name in S3?
Sorry, come again. Buckets in?
Can we define same bucket name in the two different regions? Is it allows?
Same bucket region.
Suppose XYZ is the bucket name. This XYZ can allow in two different regions?
Like, region is like what we are in GCP Hadoop, where region is like thing, but storage systems where we have to use replications like that. Are you talking region?
No, AWS S3 bucket you have specified, right? In your project.
Yeah.
In that, Amazon S3 allows, whether it allows same bucket name in two different regions.
You are talking about the storage buckets, right? I am talking about like a hive partitions and bucketing like that.
No.
Two different reasons. In GCP, it is possible. In AWS, I have not much idea about that. In GCP, we are possible in nearline storage. We have cold line storage in a different region. In AWS, I have not much of idea.
Okay.
Firstly, I have given by...
Have you heard about SGSS Federation?
Federation?
SGSS Federation.
HDFS Federation is like adding a number of name nodes. It has no limited number of name nodes. For example, like active name node, passive name node, where active name node falls, that passive name node come into conclusion without high availability, second name node not come into picture. Where in federations is like... there is no limit of name node. We can add We can add name nodes.
Okay. What is checkpointing in name node?
Checkpointing in name node is like it will merge that FS image and edit logs to get a new image, like whenever it starts that FS image.
How do you restore the existing FS image file with the new name node service?
With the new name node service. We have in edit logs, and previously we have that that if the name node is files, if we have that edit logs, we can do that FS image from that.
Edit logs?
Without high availability, we have secondary name node which will do that capture of FS image. It will do secondary name node use that FS image to that which one is running.
Due to some crash, if that edit logs is crash cleaned up by unfortunately. How do you recover those edit logs?
For 10 point of times, secondary name node, we have captured that FS image, right? So we can take it from secondary name node.
But the current logs will not be there in the secondary name node, right? That secondary name node holds only the FS image file.
Yes, yeah.
But I need the edit logs of the present activities of the... name node. If that crash due to some of the unfortunate event,
okay.
How do you recover those edit logs?
I'm not taking this.
Okay. I'm done.
Have you ever implemented this broadcast variable concept in your application?
I have used the broadcast join.
What is the difference between transformations and actions in Spark?
Transformation is we have to do the operations on the data nodes. If you want to take that to display, to take in a driver mode, we have to take action. Whenever we define an action, the transformation will not. Basically, Apache Spark is lazy evaluation. Whenever an action submitted, at that time only transformation get operated and get back to.
Can you please give some examples? What are the actions and what are the transformations?
In transformations, we have narrow transformation and wide transformations. So where In a narrow transformations, we have map, flat map, and map, flat map, and what we call in a weight transformation, we have group by key intersections, joints, Cartesians, and actions like we have take, count, count by key, reduce.
Okay. What is the difference between Spark session and Spark context?
Spark, from a two-pointer, Spark session come into picture. See, Spark context is whenever a user submit a job in Spark context, it will do whatever the programs can do. But when multiple user connected, for every user we have to create some Spark context. What the Apache has do is like why we have to create Spark context. Better we have to keep one Spark context, and we have to define a Spark session on it. That Spark session connects with a Spark context, and that whatever the program will submit, it will take that data.
Can I create tables in Spark without using Hadoop?
Sorry.
Can I create tables by using Spark SQL without Hadoop?
Yeah, we can create.
Where metadata will be stored, or where actual data will be stored?
Actual data, various storage. Spark engine will have not will don't have that file management system. Whatever it may be, whether we have in S3 bucket, we have in GCP, whether it is a data factory, whatever it may be. Apache Spark has a separate whatever we are connecting that storage engine.
My question is, every table have its own metadata, right?
Yes. Yeah.
That metadata information, where it will store if there is no Hadoop?
I think it will create some Derby meta store, maybe it default meta store.
Are you sure? Spark does have capability to store metadata its own?
Spark metadata, it will connect, it will work on a Hive meta store.
I said we are not using Hive at all. We are not using Hadoop at all. So without Hive or Hadoop, can Spark create, or where Spark can create metadata of its table?
It will have different metadata. Yeah.
What version of Cloudera? You are using Cloudera, right? What are you?
Yeah, Cloudera on premise.
What is the version?
No. 3.6 or something.
Cloudera version. Do you know what is the present version of Cloudera?
No.
But you are working daily on Cloudera, right? You're supposed to know the version of the Cloudera that you are been using.
Yes, but we are working on Hadoop, so I have not figured out that.
What is the Spark version that you have used? PySpark version?
PySpark version, I have worked on 2.1.1 Spark, which are used.
Python? Python version?
Python 3.6.
Mm-hmm. So, last question. I will explain one scenario. Okay. You can answer SQL or Hive, no problem. So, let us say there is a supermarket. Okay.
Okay.
Everyday customers will come.
Okay.
Now, we are in September month, right? So in August month, a supermarket owner wants to know, 3 consecutive days, more than 100 customers, when more than 100 customers came continually. So what is the query that you will write? Let us say there are 3 fields. One is phone number, name, and date. Customer phone number, customer name, and date. Okay, these are the 3 fields. In the table, phone number, name, and date of visit.
Okay.
These are three.
Date is like timestamp, right?
Yeah, of course, timestamp.
Yeah, okay.
So three fields are there in the table. Now, as a owner of the supermarket, I want to know how many days or how many consecutive days that customers has visited of total more than 100.
More than 100.
Let us say on first leave it. The second, third, fourth. Continually you know, 120 customers came and 100 customers came and 200 customers came. That means continuously, you know, customers, you know, crossing 100, right? As a total.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I want that output. I want that output. What is the query that you will write? Or at least, you know, tell me the pseudo code or your approach.
Based on a timestamp, we can based on timestamp is consecutive is like day by day, right? Day by day, based on the timestamp, we can select that customer.
I want to know as an output days, I mean date and number of customers visited.
Okay.
I want that output.
Number of customer visited. Select count of star from that table. Based on that timestamp.
How it will give count?
It will give right for every data for every timestamp like for see for example today is date timestamp for that particular timestamp like date day month year.
Sorry, pardon
that me. Day we have
don't take it timestamp. Let us say only date, first day, second day, third day, fourth day, like that. Okay. I want result as day and number of customers visited.
Then select a date and count of star from that table, group by that timestamp date.
Yeah, I will get output as a you know days and count of you know number of visitors, right?
Number of visitors. Yes,
I want final output as consecutive days only. I want where more than 100 customers visited.
Where more than 100 customer is created, right? We have to write subqueries like select number of customers and phone number from where we have to submit a subquery. We have to take that count of star and that inner query take into that whatever I told before count of star. Then we have to take like A is greater than or equal to, greater than 100. That subquery makes as a one name, and we can create like A is 100 greater than 100.
You are almost there. I think if you give some time, I think you can get it. So can you please give me the order of having and group by and where, which will execute first?
Group by have. Group by order, group by having?
Where? These three are there, right? So which one execute first? Give me order.
Where is executed first? After that, group by, after that, order by.
Not order by, having.
Having, where? Group by having.